You see it?
Yep.
So you want to take one?
Mehdi is very abstract and thinks very picturesque and emotionally and thinks of abstract things. And I think very analytical. So I thought about what is it that we're really interested in portraying. And for this specific movie, it was the concept of grief. This is what I recognized that fascinated Mehdi, but also I still have, but really started back then, was a fascination of life and death. And so I knew that to build a story that focused on the concept of grief, I need like intertemporality, I need more than one time line. And so I built around that. I built around characters and like what needs to be the center of it and what needs to happen. And you know, the ins and outs, and everything was focused around this central concept of grief. So that's really what I used as my compass. I remember Mehdi saying, I asked him like, what do you want to achieve with this movie? And he said, I really want people to leave the cinema and call whoever they love and tell them they love them. And so I kept that as my mantra. When he told me that, I knew that, okay, I understand what he wants to like pass on to people. And so I used that as like a guiding point as well.
Like the next movie we're gonna make, I have already the final cut in my head, and I think if Milad think about the scenes, he has the final cut in his head too, like all the things. So there was a couple of days where we were on set and we want a specific kind of feelings on the scenes, and nobody could understand it, but it, because we can see the final cut in our heads, we can see this scene and this reason this actor has to do this because we want this. And sometimes it's difficult to communicate with other people when you're not used to making movies. So, but yeah, we are very much in sync and has cut the movie already in our head. So it's just the way how we communicate to other people that we work on.
A good example is like there's a scene in the school where they're a walk and talk outside the school. Yeah. And Mehdi spent 3 days finding the right bell sound, like, And, you know, the sound editor showed him like different sounds for 3 days, but
it's specific.
Exactly. Yeah. And the same fashion, I think when we had the drone shots as like the middle layer of the movie, like the B-roll kind of thing, we would sit and argue for like weeks about and cut or like and cut. Like the difference between that and the drone shot would be like what we argued about for so long. And that's the level of specificity of our differences in the final cut, because we already know what we're talking about with each other.
It's always believe in your own idea, because this is your idea is the best idea in the world. This is how I go to meetings. Like, what I have, it's what you want. So I create a need in people's minds. And then they're gonna support us, buy it. So it's start with having an idea where you believe in it 100%. No matter who says to you it's not a good idea or the idea is shitty, just believe in it, find a better idea and always be prepared for an answer. So
listen, smile, agree, and then go do whatever the fuck you were gonna do anyway.
Yeah. Do it as you have it in your mind instead of compromise things.
Be really into your idea and have like some kind of structure and surprise. Don't like go after super weird. If you're making something to like show to other people and say this is my abilities, I know how to operate a camera, or I know how to write, or I know how to direct. Make it mainstream. Like, don't try to make some weird shit with like a balloon who's also an orange who has a father that's a potato. Make something normal so you can have a common language with everyone else, because then you can make the weird shit after you have people's trust and you have shown your skills. Focus on something mainstream, make it really well. Like, don't be cheap on like what's going into the frame. Be cheap on stuff you can't see in the frame.